very warm welcome this evening to Chester Cathedral and to those also who are joining us online. We'll now sit for Psalms 47, 48 and 49.
Thank you.
Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 42, commencing at the first verse. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed will he not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be crushed until he has established justice in the earth, and the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says the Lord, the God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes forth it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord. That is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and the new things I now declare. Before they bring forth, I tell you of them. Here endeth the first reading.
Thank you.
Our second reading is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, commencing at verse 14. Then Jesus, filled with the power of the Spirit, returned to Galilee, and a report about him spread through all the surrounding country. He began to teach in the synagogues and was praised by everyone. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." Here endeth the second lesson. I believe in God the Father, Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father, Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our anthem this evening is the Benedicite by Henry Purcell.
Oh,
Let us pray. We focus our prayers this evening on the countries and people of Turkey and Syria. We pray for first responders, and we pray for energy and strength as they work around the clock to save lives. For hospitals in the areas affected, which are overflowing. For resilience for health workers as they respond. For capacity to treat people who are injured, and for resources, medicine, equipment, and hospital beds to be readily available. For comfort for those who have lost loved ones, and healing for people who are injured. For provision for safe shelter, food, clean water, warmth for people who have lost their belongings, homes and livelihoods. That vulnerable people will be protected, and that no one will have to suffer alone. For freedom from anxiety and fear for people who are feeling distressed, particularly those already in fragile situations throughout this region. For aid agencies throughout the world as they send aid and people to assist in the disaster. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. In our diocese, we pray for the Reverend Canon Michael Burgess, the Reverend Trevor Legg, and Geoffrey Hardman. In the parish of Utrington, encourage them in their ministries and their outreach in the building projects. In our diocesan partnership, we pray for the Diocese of Melanesia, especially the Diocese of Banks and Torres, for Bishop Patterson Alfred Warwick and the staff at diocesan headquarters in Sola. For the Mothers' Union in the province, their president, Pamela Abana, and for their work with satellite churches, literacy programs, couple counseling, the Girls' Friendly Society, savings clubs, and the Positive Parenting Program. In the worldwide Anglican Communion, we pray for Peshawar, the United Church of Pakistan, for their leadership and people in the diocese. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit, and especially for Reg Taylor, and all those who have been cared for in this city this night. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them to the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. Lord God, surround all today who mourn with your continued compassion, and especially the families of Chris Woodward. Hold them in your arms, this and those others known to us who are no longer with us. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. We give thanks for this cathedral. And this evening we pray for the members of our nave choir and for Alex as he leads them. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.